What's up, y'all? Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, please subscribe and hit that bell. That's right next to the subscribe button so you can be notified every time I upload a video. Y'all don't want to miss these videos. This is only the beginning. I'm about to come with some fire content for the rest of the year and next year also. So if you're already subscribed, please like this video, comment down below more videos y'all want to see me do, and let's get into it. So today I'm working with IC Hair Company. As y'all can see, I just unboxed the wig. This is a 12 inch Peruvian 13x4 frontal wig. I'm just showing y'all the lace, and I was laughing because my boyfriend was looking at me and he was making me nervous because he know I'm new to this. So I gotta get a little more comfortable with the camera and all this voiceover things. But anyways, yeah, this is the wig, and I just wanted to show y'all the lace, and it was minimum shedding. So for the first part, you want to go ahead and bleach your knots. You're gonna need BW2 bleach and a developer. I mean, you don't have to necessarily use this brand that I'm using, because I know some people use the other brand, but as long as you have your bleach and your developer, you're fine. I use 40. I just think it's even, and it bleached faster the higher the developer number you go, but 40 is what I usually use. So right now I'm just mixing them, just mixing it up. The consistency you want for this, for your bleach, is like, I would say like a toothpaste type of consistency. So you don't want it, like y'all see how I'm picking it up with the brush, and it's not, it's like kind of thick, it's not dripping down. You don't want a liquidy, you don't want your bleach to be liquidy, because it's just gonna leak through your lace, and it's just gonna ruin the wig, and you're gonna have to do some more steps that's unnecessary. As long as you follow these steps, you'll be fine. So now I'm just hot combing the hair on the hairline back, just to make sure everything is in place, so everything is getting bleached correctly. So now I take my brush and I'm spreading that bleach onto the lace. So another thing, when you're spreading the bleach onto your lace, you want to have a light hand. Don't go heavy handed on there like you spreading butter or something on the slice of bread, because this is not it, okay? This is not it. You're going to use a light hand to evenly spread that bleach onto the lace, and you want to get it on the whole lace. Sometimes I see people just put it on like halfway where the hairline is gonna be, but me, I prefer to put it over the whole lace. So that's what I'm doing now. And like I was saying, use a light hand, because you do not want that bleach to leak through, and it's gonna just ruin the whole hairline of your wig. It's gonna be blonde. Your hairline is gonna be blonde if it leaked through, and then you're gonna have to go through a whole process, like I said before. So really be careful during this step. It's really important. So now I let it sit for about 15 minutes, and as y'all can see on the hairline, it's a difference from before I bleached it. So you can see it's kind of like a brownish color. So that's, once you see that, you know it's time for it to rinse out. So now I'm just rinsing out the bleach. When you're rinsing out the bleach, you want to make sure you rinse it completely out, because if you leave any bleach on that hair, you will see it afterwards, and you will smell it and everything, and you will feel the difference in the hair, and you will damage the hair. So make sure you get that, all the bleach out of the hair. I'm using my silicone shampoo and conditioner. I do use the purple shampoo for the brassiness on the lace, but I didn't have any, so that's another reason why I didn't let the bleach sit too long. Once I seen it getting a little brown, I just rinsed it out, because if I left it on a little longer, you would really see that brassiness on the lace. And I know I didn't have the purple shampoo, so I just avoided that and used the shampoo and conditioner that I had. It was still fine. It still came out great. So yeah, just make sure you're washing it really good. When you're washing wigs, some people don't know, but you should wash it as if it's your real hair. Make sure you really wash it. If you have to shampoo it twice, do that. Like, leave the conditioner. I let my conditioner sit for a couple minutes before I rinse it out also. So I treat it as if it was my real hair, because in order to have a long-lasting wig, and even the styling comes in with washing too. Like, you have to make sure you wash that hair real good in order to style it right. Okay, so if y'all don't really get what I'm saying, think about it like you washing your hair, and you know how it gets stiff, or it's a little stiff because you didn't wash it right or whatever. Think of it like that. So yeah, so I just washed it, and like I said before, I let my conditioner sit for about 10-15 minutes. So keep watching. So once I finished rinsing everything out, I went ahead and started my plucking method. Some people pluck when the hair is dry, some people pluck when it's wet. I do both, to be honest. So today I'm gonna be showing y'all how to pluck when your hair is wet. So I sectioned out the very beginning of the hairline, and I'm just combing everything to the back. So when you're plucking, well, when I'm plucking, I like to do it like by section. And what I mean by that is, like, y'all see what I'm doing now, like I'm just doing like the bottom half first before I move on to the next section and the next section. If y'all watching, y'all should see exactly what I mean. But yeah, this way is easier for me, because I can see exactly what I plugged, and then I just move on and try to follow everything I did prior. Okay, so that's what I'm doing now. And when you're plucking, you want to pluck behind the hairline, period. Okay, you don't want to pluck directly on the hairline, so you want to pluck just a little bit behind it. And another thing is, never pluck in the same spot. So as I can see, my hands, I'm going like in a up and down motion with my hand. I'm not plucking in one spot. If you do this, you might accidentally create a bald spot in your wig, and that's what you really don't want to do. That's because you just don't want no bald patches in your wig, especially if it's your client's wig. Okay, so, and another thing, don't be too rough, because you can poke a hole in your lace also while plucking. But yeah, this is my plucking method. It's pretty simple and self-explanatory. I told y'all the basics: pluck behind the hairline and don't pluck in the same spot. Once you get it the look that you want, just move on to the next section and repeat the same thing. So when I'm doing a 13x4, I part out three sections. So I do three sections on each side, and I just pluck and pluck. So y'all gonna see me do this side and half of the other side. So just stay tuned and keep watching. Thank you. So now that I've finished parking this side, I'm just pushing all the hair back to see my progress. And it's looking good, but you just need one more step before you move on to the next side. So what you're gonna do is you're still gonna pluck behind the hairline, okay? So you're just gonna go in and just, you know, make a few adjustments, a few changes. I'm still plucking behind the hairline. I just did a little bit of this. So now I'm just hot combing the hair back. You want to hot comb it back or comb it back, whatever, so you could just see how you did and if you wanted to pluck more or whatever. So mine was good. I didn't have to go over and pluck it anymore. As you can see, you can actually see through the lace more at the very beginning of the hairline. So that's the goal. You don't want to pluck too much, but you want to give it a natural look. And I just went in again and just made a few adjustments. Y'all probably gonna have to do this, you know, it's just perfecting your craft and making it look how you want it to look. So now I'm on the next side, and I'm doing the same exact thing I did on the other side to this side. I know, but I say whatever you do to one side, you do to the other. So yeah, self-explanatory, y'all just keep watching. I'm doing the exact same thing I did on the other side. So I'm finally done plucking. I'm just hot combing the hair. I know y'all wondering, like, why is the hair still wet? Why you just didn't blow dry after you plucked it? I'm gonna explain why. But right now I'm just hot combing all the hairs back in place. Okay. And the hairline is looking flawless, y'all. Plucking is really an important part in when customizing a wig, because I know it's time consuming, but if you want your wig and style to be flawless, you have to be patient and take your time and pluck your hairline. Pluck the lace is going to give you the best outcome, I promise. So yeah, I'm just putting everything back into place. She was actually doing the middle part, so I just went ahead and put a middle part in it. But I didn't like pluck the middle part or nothing like that. I did that once I installed it, but I just did it so I could just style it some type of way while I pull it back. But I know y'all see that hairline. If y'all want y'all hairlines on y'all ways to look like this, please follow all the steps that I just did, y'all. I promise y'all gonna have a flawless outcome and a flawless install. Promise you. So continue watching. So now, the reason I had the hair wet this whole time is because I'm going to mold the wig and I'm gonna let it air dry. So I just go in with my mousse and I'm just molding the wig. This is literally what I'm doing. I'm molding it so it can just be like this in place when I install it. It makes the installation process a little more easier. It eliminates the flyaway hairs also, and it's just like a pre-style. I'm basically pre-styling it. I did let it air dry because I didn't have to install it until the next day, so I had time to let it air dry. That's why I tell my clients to bring their wigs 2 days prior so I can customize it and make my job easier, a little easier, and your time shorter, so we don't have to be there all day, you know, trying to customize the wig and all that extra stuff. I just like to pre-style it before, and as I can see, look at that hairline, like it's just perfect. Like, I fell in love with this wig. I see here, I love their hair company. I've been loving their hair company. They have high quality hair and their lace is amazing. As you can see, the knots, well, I should have showed y'all before, but the knots were not dark. They was actually light. I just love that about wigs, because dark knots are just not it. They're really not it. But so now I'm just showing y'all the process, okay? So this was really it. I hope y'all enjoyed the video. I hope y'all learned something from the video. So make sure y'all comment down below anything y'all learned or anything y'all want to comment, what y'all want to see me do next. Make sure y'all like this video, please, and subscribe. Until next time, bye.